Hello investors, welcome to Business Learnings. In this video, I'll be talking about the market cap to GDP ratio. The video will be short, but it will be full of learning. That's why I would recommend that you watch the video throughout the end and do subscribe to the channel so that you do not miss out on more such videos. Right? In this video, we'll be talking about the market cap to GDP ratio, also known as the Warren Buffett indicator. It tells us how much overvalued the market is currently, the stock market, the equity market is currently. Right, and accordingly, you can take calls on when to buy or when to sell. Right, we'll also be talking about what should you do as an investor at this point in time. So market cap to GDP ratio, as the name suggests, market cap divided by the GDP of the country, the current market cap of the country divided by the current GDP of the country. Today, for India, the market cap to GDP ratio is about 1.78. Which means the market cap is about 1.78. The market cap of all the listed companies in the Indian stock market is about 1.78 times more than the GDP of the country. And this GDP is calculated as per the RBI's guidance provided for the financial year FY21-22. Which means that we are not using any older data. We are using a more recent, a current data with some future projections, and this year's data will already factor in the growth which was supposed to happen because we had recovered from the pandemic, right? So that's one. Right now the ratio is 1.78, and historically in the last 15 years, if you calculate the median of market cap to GDP, you will find that it is hovering around 0.75. When do we say that the market cap to GDP ratio, or let's say the market is overvalued? In the Indian context, we say that the market is overvalued when this ratio is more than 1. Right now it is 1.78, which means the markets are highly overvalued. When do we say that the markets are undervalued? We say the markets are undervalued when this ratio is less than 0.7. For example, last year in March 2020, when the markets were at their all-time lows, this ratio was about 0.55, approximately 0.55, which means the markets were highly undervalued. That means that it made a lot of sense for any investor to go and buy a lot of stocks. Today, this ratio is 1.78. Historically, during the 2007 and 2008 crash, you know, the markets had reached a peak just before the 2007 and 8 crash. And during that peak, the ratio was 1.5. The current valuations are exorbitantly high, extremely high. Therefore, you should be worried as an investor. You should be careful. You should not be feeling the fear of missing out. You should not be investing, especially at this point in time. You should not be investing with lump sum money. Now, a lot of people here might say that, hey, since this is a ratio of market cap to GDP, and we have recently seen that a lot of IPOs have come into picture in the last 1 year, so doesn't that automatically increase the market cap, and that's why the ratio will also increase? You are right, but it does not impact by that much, that quantum. In the last one and a half year, the total money raised by the IPOs are about 1.1 lakh crore rupees, right? And the market cap of all such companies was approximately, it would be less than 10 lakh crore rupees. The market cap of all the listed companies in India today, it is approximately 400 lakh crore rupees. What is 10 lakh crore rupees compared to 400 lakh crore rupees? Just 2.5%. So the ratio would have changed by 2.5%, not more than that. That's why, even in that scenario, the market cap to GDP ratio would have been at its all-time high, and that is why we feel that even if the IPOs had not had come, we would still be sitting in an overvalued position. What should you do as an investor? There are two things that you should be keeping into mind. Number one is, if you are in for the long term, if you are betting on India and you are going to stay invested for the long term, stay invested, because 5 or 10 years down the line, the growth rates are still looking very impressive. But if you are looking for some short-term gains, for instance, you have just started investing, and you are thinking that, and the reason that I'm talking about this is because a lot of investors have very recently entered into the market. They have never seen a bear market, and if you are one of them, if you have never seen a bear market, you have just seen your money grow double or triple in the past 1 year. Trust me that this is not going to be the case in the next 1 to 2 years. The market might get stagnant, you might get frustrated. If you are in for the long term, if you have that kind of a patience that you will stay invested for the next a decade or so in good quality companies, do so. But if you are in for a very short term, please be very careful, because you will be investing your hard-earned money in the markets, right? Now next, finally, I want to talk about what did I do. I have recently started reducing my equity exposure. Earlier, I was exposed, I had about 75% exposure in equity and about 25% in debt, gold and different asset classes. Right now, I am sitting on 60% equity and 40% cash, gold and other assets, including debt. Right? So I, as an investor, I will keep on reducing my equity exposure as the markets will keep on reaching new heights. I am completely fine with the FOMO. Even if the market goes, let's say Nifty is sitting at approximately 18,000 at this point in time, even if it goes at 25,000 levels, I should be fine with that feeling of missing out, that hey, I should not have exited the market when it was at 18,000. Now I had missed about 33-34% kind of a rally. I should not be worried about that. If you have that kind of a conviction, if you do not get deterred by how people around you are behaving, how your friend circle, how your colleagues and the investment circle, the decisions that they are taking, the returns that they are making, if you are not bothered by them and you are absolutely sure, then you should be fine. Otherwise, if you are a novice, I would suggest that please stay invested for the long term. And if you are planning to get, if you are thinking that you might get multi-bagger kind of returns, the kind of returns that you have received the last 1.5 years, and you will continue receiving that kind of a return, it won't happen. It most likely will not happen. So yep, this is all that I want to talk about in this video. Please put down any questions that you have related to this topic. No one can predict where the markets will go, but all we can do is stay prepared mentally. See you in the next video. Bye.